So Jack Dorsey put this out, and yes, I wish I was making this up, spent the weekend building Bitchat. Hey everybody, I've been getting a lot of messages about Jack Dorsey's new messenger and whether or not you should use it. Now, full disclaimer, this is an impressions video. I'm just gonna give you the breakdown of what it is, as well as kind of some basics on the security protocols and stuff like that. Now, the main highlight feature is that this supposedly doesn't require internet, meaning it's peer-to-peer, which means that you're directly communicating with other people. Now, this works over Bluetooth, and the best way to describe it is like a mesh network. And actually, this is how Apple does its AirTag technology. Pretty much the reason why you can find your AirTags isn't because they have a GPS chip inside of them, it's because there are so many iPhones everywhere that if your AirTag is within iPhone range, that iPhone can essentially like function as part of the network and let you know where that AirTag is located. This can be generally repurposed into something like a messenger, where if many people inside, let's say a big warehouse, let's say you work inside a factory, if everybody has a phone and they have this app installed, theoretically they can all communicate with one another. He says it enables ephemeral encrypted communication between nearby devices, and it seems like a big part of this is just better resiliency, right? Around the world you'll see these random power outages, especially in places that are affected by any kind of humanitarian issues. Technology like this is really important in empowering people to communicate without even having internet access. Now, before continuing, I want to really outline that this concept isn't new. We've actually reviewed a messenger already on this channel called Briar, which is actually pretty much the same concept, no offense, Jack. It's censorship-resistant peer-to-peer messaging, it bypasses centralized servers, and it has the option to still go through servers, but you can do that over Tor. It's been third-party tested, it's been audited, it's open source, it's got a lot of good stuff. Let's see what's different and kind of the security behind what's going on here. So first, just starting with some press coverage, TechCrunch put out this article pretty much saying his secure Bitchat app has not been tested for security. Jack Dorsey put this out over a weekend. I want to make it clear too that Jack Dorsey isn't a security expert. He's not somebody who has developed encryption protocols. This isn't like his main bread and butter. So I think there is going to be a little bit of a friction point of him developing that kind of reputation. Now, this is not going to help the reputation. First off, since launching, he's already issued a warning that says this software has not received external security review and may contain vulnerabilities and does not necessarily meet its stated security goals. Do not use it for production use and do not rely on its security whatsoever until it's been reviewed, which is really good, and I'm glad he's putting a disclaimer, but I think it speaks to the state in which it's in. And you can actually find this yourself if you go to the GitHub repo for Bitchat. Now, since this went live, a researcher has already found some vulnerabilities in it, and there's a man-in-the-middle attack that you can pull off, and then the cryptographic toolbox we should be using, and they clear up what should be happening here. These are completely avoidable problems. We have battle-tested protocols, which is the signal protocol, which is the gold standard, noise protocol framework, OTR, and then existing decentralized solutions like Briar, which I've already mentioned. And one pretty nice improvement since Jack originally launched this is including the noise protocol framework, which is a much more established encryption protocol. Not quite as secure as something like Signal, as far as I can tell, but still at least better than trying to do your own thing. I also think it's funny that the researcher just has a section titled Reporting the Issue, which just has a screenshot of asking what's a good way to report security flaws, and then Jack just closes it. I just think that interaction's hilarious. This is the spirit of open source. I think it's worth taking a minute here to address why this is important. So messengers are one of the most sensitive things that you can possibly do on any of your devices. This is where you're having the most intimate discussions with people. This is where you might be sharing passwords with loved ones. Not only do we have this expectation of privacy in those contexts, but what makes this potentially even more damaging is when we have someone come forward and say, hey, I have this really resilient, really secure messaging app, go use it. And it starts giving people perhaps a false sense of security, which really amplifies the what I want versus what I'm getting ratio. And that's what we really need to be careful of with these projects. And to put this launch in context, Signal's been around for over 10 years. It's been considered the gold standard by pretty much every major security expert out there in terms of its encryption protocol itself. It has years of security audits, peer review, it's been analyzed by researchers, and Bitchat was just released a couple weekends ago with really none of that kind of rigorous oversight.
Many people don't consider that the notes they take are actually extremely sensitive, and there are many privacy implications about where this data goes and who has access to it. The sponsor of this video is Notesnook, and they're aiming to make notes more private and secure, especially relative to some other mainstream counterparts. Notesnook is open source. They have many features you'd expect to find in other very popular productivity tools. It's all end-to-end encrypted, meaning they can't even see your data if they wanted to, checklists and reminders, and they just released a V3 rebranding, which looks phenomenal. If you're somebody who wants to keep your current productivity but improve the safety of that productivity, Notesnook is pretty much a no-brainer. And again, it's open source, and also they have a really solid free offering too, so there's no risk in trying it out. And they make it super easy to switch to from your current tools. Check out Notesnook down in the description, and I really want to thank Notesnook for sponsoring our content. We really can't do it without great services like them. So thank you, and go check out Notesnook down in the description.
So I really want to establish here, and this is going to get into what I want to see as well as my personal opinion on this. I think this is great. I'd love to see, especially like traditional big tech bros, see the need for more privacy-respecting technologies, to see these mesh protocols, to see resilient ways to communicate with those around you in even the most extreme circumstances. This has big potential. What I would love to see, though, and here are kind of the changes, I would love to see proper security audits, proper review processes. Hopefully by now there's an easier way to actually report vulnerabilities. I still don't see a security file in here. Yeah, there's still no security policy detected, so I'm not really quite sure what's going on there. There is no releases under this repo, which means there is no APK that you can just easily sideload on Android. I would really love to hear Jack's personal thoughts on, like, why did he build this? Why was this his weekend activity? Does he plan to continue it? Why didn't he just put his money into Briar or try to improve Briar, which is something that already exists, is very established, is already used by journalists, and kind of seems to do everything that Bitchat does, but without all the current glaring problems. And so I would love to hear why, in the long run, Bitchat is going to do something different from Briar or Signal or any of these other messengers. And I mentioned Signal a lot, but Session, SimpleX, Threema, all of these messengers have pretty much all the characteristics I already shared with you in terms of being proper privacy and security messengers. Now, it's not all negative. I do like how Bitchat is ephemeral by default. So messages exist only in device memory, which I think is really fantastic. I do love how there's no registration. There's no accounts, emails, or phone numbers required. That is fantastic and is definitely a step forward for privacy. The other thing I'd love to see and no. So one issue with Briar is it's Android only, and the reason why it's Android only is your device has to be essentially online. I know it doesn't need internet, but your device needs to be on and connected to the app the whole time. When it's peer-to-peer, there is no central server, which means both people have to be online at the same time for the messages to actually be delivered. And so Briar's Android only because there is no real background sync on iOS. So I'm really curious to see how this app is going to work with that kind of limitation. And unfortunately, it's already a full beta, so I can't actually test it myself. But that's something I'd love to see in maybe a more full in-depth review. So this concept has a lot of merit, and I think it's really good that Jack is developing something that is overall a really good mission. But I think it needs a lot more time to mature. When I say a lot, I mean like weeks, months, potentially years. I mean, these messengers we currently have took them years to get where they are today. And that's not to discourage new people from entering the scene. It's just the reality that they have a really, really solid reputation. I also want to cover quick alternatives as well. On our site, techlore.tech/resources, we have resources for all the privacy and security tools out there, overall the best ones. And if you go to messengers, you're going to find things like Briar, Signal. Molly's a fork of Signal that makes it a bit more feature-rich on Android. SimpleX, Session, Matrix, and Threema. These are all fantastic messengers, and there's actually a best messaging apps video that I put out that you can also watch there. Overall, my takeaway for this video is keep in mind innovation versus caution. There might be some really cool ideas out there that could be fantastic ideas for privacy and security, but it doesn't mean that when they're released, they are the most privacy and security respecting way of doing those ideas. Stay hungry, find new things, but still be cautious when doing so, and maybe don't use it for production, which is actually the same disclaimer that they currently still have on their GitHub. I want to thank Notesnook. I want to thank all of you for watching, and I'll see you next time on Techlore. Let me know your thoughts below. I'd love to hear.